The CraftBot 3 is our new high-level 3D printer. It introduces several new features that set it apart from previous CraftBots. The CraftBot 3 is the first 3D printer that introduces a filament monitoring system. You no longer have to worry that your prints are going to fail because you run out of filament or because it jams in the middle. The system will automatically monitor the filament that's flowing through the print heads, and if it detects a problem, it will automatically try to resolve the problem itself. If it can't resolve that problem, or if you run out of filament entirely, then it will notify you on your mobile device so that you can resolve the issue yourself and restart printing right from where you left off. In addition to the filament monitoring system, we've also introduced two independent print heads. Now, this is different than in previous iterations. Because they move independently, you can not only use them to print a single object with two different materials or two different colors, but you can also set the print heads in different modes to achieve even more. In the parallel mode, you can print two identical objects side by side with the print heads moving independently. In mirror mode, you can print two halves of a single object and then assemble it later. But in support mode, you can actually use and dedicate one of the print heads to printing PVA support material. And at the end of your print, you'll be able to dissolve it in water and thereby create much more intricate and detailed objects. Now, in addition to the filament monitoring system and the two independent print heads, we've also added several additional features to the CraftBot 3 that make it unique. We've added a brand new quieter motor control system. We've also added complete metal hot ends on both print heads. We've introduced the new multicolor LED light so that you know what's going on with the printer. And we've added a new ball screw and rail system for increased accuracy. Now, like all previous CraftBots, the CraftBot 3 is plug and play and is ready to print right out of the box. But today I'm going to show you a couple of configuration options so that you can get the most out of your printer. To get started with your CraftBot 3, the first thing you're going to do is load your filament. Go ahead and install the filament holders and the encoders on both sides of the printer. Then simply load the filament through the bottom of the encoder, up through the plastic tubing, and into the print head. Just like on previous CraftBots, you'll use your extruder menu in order to load the filament into the hot end for your first use. To level the bed on the CraftBot 3, we'll use the same process as we did in previous CraftBots. We'll simply navigate into the settings menu and locate the icon for leveling the bed. Looks like three crosshairs. If necessary, your printer will heat itself up. But once it's to the necessary temperature, we're ready to go ahead and level the bed. Now we'll follow the on-screen instructions, which give us some guidance as to how to adjust the bed so that it's perfectly level. Now once the printer homes into its homing position, it will move the first print head to the front of the plate. Now once the print heads have moved into position, we'll use the provided card in order to check the distance between the print head and the bed. If it feels like there's too much room or not enough room, then we'll use the guidance from the on-screen instructions in order to adjust the bed so that it's perfectly level. Now we're going to repeat this process three different locations on the print bed. And once we've moved through all three locations, our bed should be perfectly level. And now we're ready to print. Calibrating the XY axis on the new CraftBot 3 is especially important because of the two independent print heads. Basically, if we send each print head to the same coordinates, it should land in the exact same spot on the print bed. If we don't do this, then we might find in the final object that the two materials don't line up well or that they have gaps between them. In order to coordinate the X and Y axis, we're going to enter into the settings menu and navigate to the icon that looks like three different coordinate systems, and that'll get us started. Now you can calibrate either the X-axis, the Y-axis, or both depending on your needs. I'll show you today how to do both. If necessary, the printer will heat itself up since you actually will be printing. And as soon as it's heated itself up, it'll actually begin printing one of the scales. It's going to print out a series of marks, and those are the marks that you'll use in order to make sure that the two print heads are aligned properly. And once it's done printing the first scale, it'll go ahead and start printing the other scale for the other axis. And what you'll notice is that some of the lines are not aligned with each other in one direction, and other lines are not aligned with each other in the other direction, but somewhere right in the middle, the lines will actually line up perfectly. And once the scales have been printed, we'll start counting from this inside corner. So from here, we'll count up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Now that one to me looks like it's the best align. It's either going to be 15 or maybe 16. Depending on which one you think is most aligned correctly, you'll simply input that value using the touchscreen panel and do the same count for the other scale. So having input those on our touchpad, I simply say yes, and now we're done. We need to calibrate the two encoders before the filament management system is ready to use. To do this, we'll simply enter the settings menu and navigate to the encoder settings icon, which looks like a spool of filament with two glasses on it. From here, we have a couple of different options. The first is we can actually turn the entire filament management system on and off. Our at icon allows us to enter an email address that the printer can contact us at in case of any problems. And our final icon is where we'll actually do the calibration. Now to start, simply pick the material that you'll be using for the calibration. Here we're using PLA and our print heads are already heated up, so we'll move directly into calibrating the encoders. At this point, the print heads are actually going to extrude a specific amount of filament that makes sure that the print head and the encoders are set to the same level. Assuming there are no problems, the machine will let you know that you have successfully calibrated each of the heads. Now you can see that our first head has actually been calibrated, so we'll go back in and calibrate the second head. Now we can see on our display that not only is our filament management system on, both encoders have been calibrated, and the printer has an email address to contact you at in case of any problems. Now that we've calibrated the machine, you can start printing.